Okay, it's our pleasure to welcome back John Sipple for the second half of the John Sipple Day. And hopefully now he'll have some important information to share with us, which will help us to kind of summarize the day.
I'm still trying to emotionally recover from the fact that Jim, the speaker just before this, made all his mathematical calculations during my talk earlier. counting all the light bulbs and all that. Or maybe it's one of the others, but probably mine. all right, what I wanted to do and what I was encouraged to do was to share with you a couple tools to what we call democratizing some of this data and democratizing access to some certain tools and so forth to make life very easy to inform local decisions. So I want to take just literally, hopefully 5 or 10 minutes and share a couple of these things, show you where to find them, because you can then do this on your own. And this is one of these take-home projects that I think you'll find fun. It's a guaranteed laugh every time I say this, but take this to your next party on a Friday night, some of these tools, which you haven't seen the tools yet, so you're not laughing yet, but once you see them, you'll laugh. This can really inform local neighborhood conversations in your own house, at your school board, wherever it may be. And then I think we should just open up some Q&A and just begin some conversation around some of these issues, and then we'll try to wrap up by 3 or so, or whenever Jim gives the hook, go from there. Okay, this is our website. If any of you are Facebook users, and you don't have to be, but if you are, and what I've realized the last 2 years is there's not a lot of folks out in rural areas who use Facebook. I have a grand total of 97 people who have liked our site after 2 years of this. So if we can get it to 100 today, that would be a huge accomplishment. I won't even mention Twitter. although I did tweet something, and Cornell tweeted something about this event today, and a couple different organizations retweeted it. So there's a lot of people that know about this. If you have any idea what that means, great. If not, don't worry about it. So. Okay. This is the website for our center, which doesn't have much of a staff other than me. We had some state money back in 2008 and 2009 to what we call build connections, capacity, and knowledge. And really make, there's a lot of people around the state working on similar issues, so trying to build connections between those people, build a capacity by putting information in the hands of those people, research information, and what we found to be really, really welcome by people is just easy access to data. How to find enrollment trends for your district or any other district. You often hear the story of somebody showing up at a board meeting and saying, that district down the road, they are so much more efficient than we are. They're outperforming us, and their poverty rate is this. And heretofore, it would take some real work to actually confirm that or refute that and to have an informed conversation. And I'll show you a few things today where you can do that within, 10, 15 seconds and get at some of those numbers. So this is our page. And if you go to if you have a laptop or a tablet or a phone, certain types of phones, you can do a lot of this. You just play at home. You'll play along as we're going along here. But I'll try to be quick. Capacity and data. Which is where our tools are. We go down here, and what we've done in a not a very interesting way, and I apologize, we call it the integrated data system. Not very exciting. But what it does, it pulls together all kinds of demographic data, performance data, and financial data into a single database. So you can query questions and ask for spreadsheets and look for graphs to be made and maps to be made by this information all at your fingertips. As opposed to, if you want to look at demographic trends over a bunch of years, there's a certain set of websites you can go to. You'll have to then merge 18 different spreadsheets together. If you want performance data, you'll have to start merging Microsoft Access databases because they have 3 years of data at a time. And it's just a nightmare to try and do that. Financial data, the same thing. You get all these different spreadsheets from a third set of websites. And so we've just pulled that all together for you. Everything you'll see here is all publicly available data. There's nothing secret about this. There's nothing privileged about this. This is data the state puts out very publicly every year, different points of the year. But it's a pain in the neck to use because it's not in any kind of a useful format. So that's what we've tried to do. And the feedback we've gotten has been quite quite positive about this in many different ways. But okay, you see a list of data tools here with a brief little description. And then down here, we have data tools by county, and then actually some maps down the bottom. But I'm going to focus on these district data tools, although the county data tools can be really, really useful. We talked before about the county profiles that I gave you that URL to go find. If you click on most of these, you actually get to that other website, and you can go find those county profiles. But let's say for the fun of it, I'm going to do this really, try to go really quick. This one that doesn't look very interesting, recent trends, okay? And if any of you are real marketing gurus, help us out with the name better than recent trends. I get people to use this. This comes out of a direct phone call I received from a superintendent very new to her position, not new to the superintendency, but new to a superintendency in this particular district that will go unnamed. And this goes back about 4 or 5 years. And the superintendent said, I've been a superintendent before. I just took a new job. I cannot find in this new office the financial records from this district. I don't know how much state aid they got. I'm not sure what the tax rates were. And she's going on. And I'm thinking, ooh, there's bigger issues at play here than just this phone call. But that's neither here nor there. We then, in a very short, literally it was within a week, had some earlier version of this tool up, which doesn't look like much now. But who would like to put their school district up? Where'd it go? Whew. Okay, who's got a district that they want? Wouldn't mind having it. It's all public data anyways. I'm sorry? Potsdam. So you hit P and it goes down to something? Yep, try it. Okay. Keep going. Right there. Okay, so you just find your district. And then what happens is you get a bunch of these little mini blue lines, what we call.
Pick another one.
Well, the enrollment, they all look like that. Okay, if you mouse over this, you get a big version of the little thing. If you right click on this, well, let me just click on this. If I right click on that, I can copy the image, drop it into a newsletter, and boom, you're gone. Okay, a newsletter, you can tweet it, you can Facebook it, you can print it out in the old-fashioned way. Do whatever you want with it. Okay? So you say, okay, well, that's fine. I can see these little spark lines. I can get a little chart, one variable at a time. I can look at the younger grades, the older grades, so forth. If I'm curious about a definition, I click on that little link, and it gives me the official state definition. I get some performance measures here that I can look at and click on. Okay. Percentages, I can look at the percentage of free or reduced price lunch. And you see how it bounces a little bit and so forth. Small populations, you get these bouncing. But then let's do something interesting. Okay. And these, again, how quickly can you find this information? Boom, it's right there. The question that always comes up when I ask these kind of questions is, why have schools gotten so darn expensive? And we've had some of these conversations. Well, of course, it's the teacher salaries. Of course, it's the retirement costs, health expenditures. The superintendents. And transportation, why not? Okay, so you click on whatever variables you want. You find out what's interesting to you, you click on those variables, go back to the top, and go in. Whoops. This is very temperamental. And go analyze. And what it does, it puts them on the same graph. Okay? Not rocket science, but to do that by yourself would take you a couple hours if you knew what you're doing, because of all these different databases. There you go, in a minute and a half you got your chart. And then you say, somebody says to you, is that adjusted for inflation? And the proper answer is no. So you go back here, you click here, you want constant dollars. You wait a second, all the data uploads. Okay, you analyze it again. It remembers what you had checked, and there you get these things adjusted for inflation. Okay, right click on it, copy the image, and you're off and running for your blog or whatever you're doing. Okay, recent trends. All right.
Can you look between school districts?
Can you compare different districts? And the answer to that right now is not on this tool, no. And that's a glaring flaw, I recognize that. Okay, if anybody's got any money that I could take and give to my tech guy to do this, I'll be more than willing to take it and we can do that. But because that's been requested before.
Compare these three.
But wouldn't that be great? Be able to compare two or three or five districts, or compare this district to the BOCES average, or compare it to the county average, or compare it to the state average. That would all be really useful. And so that's a resource issue at this point. Okay? So if I go back to here, that the one I just showed you is the very first tool we ever made. Very simple, and it does what it does. I keep mentioning enrollment. There's the whole thing on enrollment details. Different way to look at, again, one district at a time. Look at the K-12 enrollment rates, or look at cohorts. Look in 2006. How are the enrollment distributed across grades? You can watch for bubbles moving through. If you're at all thinking about reconsidering how you place people in or place students in different school buildings, a very useful tool. Okay. This benchmarker, we often try to compare school building performance with other school buildings, and we're sort of guessing. The state gives these comparison districts that I've never actually seen anybody use, and that signals to me that they're not very good comparisons. So we built this tool. Doesn't look like much. It is exceedingly simple. Okay. This is not a district-level tool. This is a building-level tool. So who's got a school building they want to benchmark? Meaning, find another school building that is demographically quite similar but outperforms you. So who's got a building?
Bloomingdale.
So I type in Bloom, and you see Bloomingdale School. I'm going to click on that. Okay, and what it gives me is a fancy little blue decoration up top and then a list of other buildings here. This is really not a fancy blue decoration. This is what we call the similarity index. Okay, it defaults at 90. Little number 90 shows up there. I can make these more similar by sliding this over. And this should reload and recalculate. Okay, gives me a different set of buildings. So you can make them more demographically similar or less. If you're curious what we're basing it on, the help screen gives you all the details about how it compares the buildings demographically. Okay, and let's say we're going to just let me just click on this. Oh, what did I do?
You got Bloomfield, not Bloomingdale.
Oh, where'd Bloomingdale go? Here we go. Click Bloomingdale. Okay, and then Big Tree. Have you ever heard of Big Tree Elementary? No. Usually not. What it does, it finds for you schools instantaneously that you most likely have never heard of, would never think of calling up that school because didn't even know it existed. And let's take a peek. So you click on that in a classic we, them. It's us, it's Bloomingdale, them, our Big Tree Elementary. They're an average need, you're an average need. You go to the bottom and it compares the demographics. Okay. Now they're a much bigger building, so this may not be a very good comparison because they've got 600 students and you've got 184. You can look. Click on this, you get it's a weighted average that shows up there. And get there, go back. So this may not be a good one, so I'm gonna go back. And let's go to this one. Okay, they're still much bigger, but I'm not gonna take the time up. Once you find a benchmark school that you think is demographically pretty similar, come on, there we go. You can look at the ELA assessment for the building, different subgroups, different grade levels, and so forth, and you get these comparisons. Again, that's all it does. At the very bottom, you can contact old Barbara. Okay, Barbara's the principal of this other school. Now, at first, I was a little nervous about putting this kind of information on there. I thought the only time she's ever going to be called is when the phone call, she picks up the phone, and somebody on the other end says, "Your school is doing something great that our school is not. What are you doing?" So the calls are always in the positive way. So no one's going to go complaining to her. They're going to find out what they're doing. And it creates a conversation. Okay. All right. We have a budget playground tool. I'd mentioned before multi-year budgeting. Okay. And there's two versions of this. There's one version that's on the web and one version it's built for an iPad app that you can actually right in the Apple App Store, you can go and download it and use it and so forth. And this is to create scenarios. It's a scenario building tool. I can show you a little bit what this looks like. I can't remember, we're still looking at Potsdam, and you've got expenditures here, revenues, fund balance, enrollment, and so forth. And you can go through and you can tweak this. You can build scenarios. What if state aid does this? What if our property values tank? What if our tax rate, and you play this out for however many years you want to play it out for, 2, 3, 4, 5 years. And you can simulate different scenarios very, very quickly. Just real quick, this came from I was attending a local school board meeting. I won't mention any names, but it's where I live. And this goes back a couple, 3 years ago. And the business official was, in January, was presenting the initial budgets, kind of layout for the season, kind of kicking off the budget season. And so I went. It's always a fun celebration. And a board member said, I don't think state aid's coming in there. I think it's going to be X minus whatever, something different what the business official said. Business official's response was, okay, made a note of that. I'll get back to you at the next meeting. I thought, ooh, what a lost opportunity. What a way to have a conversation. So we built this tool so that we can do changes on the fly. It doesn't cost you a penny to make the change. You just hit a button or two, and you can get as complex or as simple as you want. There's different layers or different levels of complexity. You can have the 30 different financial variables, or you can boil it down to 2 or 3, however you want to use that. Okay. So these are some tools that you can access right off our site. There's a variety, I think it's 10 different tools. I'm not going to take the time now, but just know they are there. Call or email if you have any questions with how to use them, why you might want to use them. But what most people find is just by exploring around with these things, they can answer a lot of pretty interesting questions, mainly because each one of these was derived, except for this one, which was my own experience. Every single other tool came from a request from a board member, a superintendent, or more likely a whole series of superintendents and board members who requested certain tools. Okay. The last thing I want to show you, just super quick, is Phil Martin still here? Oh, okay, yep. This is we lost our reorganizer icon. It just says reorganizer icon. Well, there's supposed to be a little picture there. Okay. This is a really quick way to go in and get some of the real rudimentary basic information about tax rates. Compare this one you can compare across schools. A bit of demographic information. And then you have it calculate the state incentive aid for merger. And so we have, again, it remembers what school district you're looking at. So here's Potsdam. So if we wanted to add that and add, I'm just going to do this quickly. Add whatever you want to the analysis, and you kick one out, and you scroll down, you instantly get your incentive aid, okay? So this is stuff that the consultants would do for you, okay? And what we've tried to do is do some of these really simple calculations, just do them for you so the consultants can go on to the much more challenging, much more politically savvy, and the stuff we can't do with simple web-based calculations. So this is not trying to remove the need to hire a consultant when you're engaged in these conversations. But often you can look at this really quickly early on and then decide whether you want to at all continue on with the conversation where you maybe approach a consultant. Okay, so you look at the enrollment. We do enrollment projections for every school district in the state. We pull those projections into this. And so you can see so individual data for the districts are right here. We project out, and this is the sum. And so the grand total we project in 2015 of about 3,700 students. That's actually up from 2014 and so forth. So a little bit of recovery out here we project, okay, for this particular set of districts. Now you determine what districts you want to play with. And if one of these you don't want, let's say, boy, we don't really want to dance with these people anymore, date with these people, boom, you exit out and they're gone. Doesn't cost you a penny. And everything recalculates. Okay? You can go to district comparisons.
You're telling
that consultant over everybody. No, because they spend most of he'll tell you, they spend most of their time on the hard stuff. This is just good to get out of the way. It will actually be more efficient with them. So here we got the combined wealth ratios.